Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, we are going to dive into our expected goals page. So to begin with, let's discuss what expected goals are. XG is a statistical measurement that measures the quality of a shot taken by a team. This measurement considers various factors before the shot is taken, such as assistant type, distance from goal, type of attack, shot angle, and body part used to shoot. This measurement can be increased by having good players on the team as the chances to score increase. XG, in simple terms, is the probability of a team or league to convert a shot into a goal. XG is different from average goals scored as a team might have high XG per game but a low number of goals. It can provide insights into how dangerous a side is or how little a team produces chances in a match. Through XG, we can see which team has more chances of scoring a goal. Despite being useful, it cannot predict the results of a game on its own. And some bookmakers now offer expected goals betting, where you can bet on which team will win on expected goals for certain leagues. FootyStats XG page offers XG stats organized by top leagues, top teams, recent matches with high XG, and XG stats for leagues. If we take a look at one of the leagues in the top leagues for XG table, we can see that the fourth league on this table has an XG of 4.20. This 4.2 represents the XG per match for the league. This number is calculated via our algorithm, which assesses all shots taken in a match within the league. Each shot taken is given a score, which is the XG, and all these scores are summed up for the total XG for the league. A 4.2 XG is a very high number for a league, which may indicate that it's a low-skilled league. If we take a look into individual teams within the league, we can see that there is a large discrepancy in XG within the league. The top teams may possess stronger attacking skills or better tactics, allowing them to create and convert high-quality chances consistently. In contrast, the remaining teams with lower XG value may suggest that the team in the league find it challenging to create high-quality scoring opportunities. Let's take a look at another league. If we compare the previous team to the Premier League's expected goal stats, whose team's XG range from 2.16 to 0.94, we can see that the gap between the lowest and highest values is narrower since this league possesses higher levels of competitiveness as the scoring opportunities across teams are relatively more balanced. The XG leagues tables that FootyStats provide contain the XG, expected goals conceded, XD, and XG versus actual. XG refers to expected goals to be scored per match. XGA stands for expected goals to be conceded. Expected goals conceded can be used to assess the defensive performance as a whole of a team. This measure quantifies the quality of scoring opportunities that a team concedes to their opponents during a match. XGD stands for the difference between expected goals and expected goals conceded. Expected goals versus actual goals measures that team's actual goals scored against expected goals scored. A negative number is bad since the team is scoring less than expected. A positive number indicates that the team is scoring more than expected. Similar stats are available in the top teams for the XG table. Furthermore, you can look at the expected goals against per match on the individual team pages for each team. A high XG against indicates that a team is conceding a larger number of high-quality scoring opportunities to their opponents. This suggests that the opponents are creating dangerous chances to score, and the team's defense is struggling to prevent those opportunities. It could imply that the team's defense or goalkeeping may be lacking, resulting in a higher likelihood of goals being conceded. If XG against is low, the team is effectively limiting the quality of scoring opportunities their opponents can create. This may indicate a solid defense. XG can be used to identify which teams consistently create high-quality scoring opportunities. A comparison of XG versus actual reveals which teams are converting those chances well or underperforming. By considering the XG stats of both teams in a match, you can estimate the likelihood of different outcomes. When a team has a consistently high XG and is facing a team with a consistently high XG to be conceded, the former has a good chance of scoring goals. In this way, you can determine the possibility of specific outcomes such as over-under goals or both teams scoring. If you found this video helpful, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more football-related content. Also, don't forget to download FootyStats on your mobile device for quicker access to many stats. Thanks for watching, and if you have any comments, questions, or feedback, feel free to leave a comment or reach out to our Twitter or email.